Hello everyone, hope you all are well. I know it's a very tough time for all of us, but don't lose your hope. Everything will be okay and we all have to move forward. Remember that a bright sun always comes after a dark night. So today I will discuss about the series AC circuit. In this AC circuit I will discuss about the RLC circuit. Series RLC circuit. So myself, Mr. Santanu Naskar, Assistant Professor of Electrical Department, GKCM GIS Group, and my mail ID is santanu.uit@gmail.com and santanu.naskar_gkcm@gisgroup.org. And this is my Facebook page, Being Electrify with Santanu. You can get all the lecture in my Facebook page and as well as in my YouTube channel. So before starting this video, I want to share with you something that was told by former President of India, that don't fear for facing failure in the first attempt, because even the successful math start with zero only. So let us talk about the syllabus. So above the course name of the subject is Electric Circuit and Network, course code WES3CTN, semester third. And about this objective I have already discussed. So about this content, review of basic concept of electric circuit I have already covered, and about the single phase AC circuit I have already covered, study of J operator and concept of complex impedance, rectangular and polar form. So today I will discuss about series AC circuit, RLC circuit. In this video I will discuss about the impedance, reactance, phasor diagram, impedance triangle, power factor, active power, apparent power, reactive power of this RLC and RLC circuit. So let's start. So what is RL circuit? An RL circuit, also known as an RL filter or RL network, is defined as an electrical circuit consisting of the passive circuit element of a resistor R and an inductor L connected together, driven by a voltage or current source. Due to the presence of a resistor in the ideal form of the circuit, an RL circuit will consume energy akin to an RC circuit or RLC circuit. This is unlike the ideal form of an LC circuit, which will consume no energy due to the absence of a resistor. Although this is only in the ideal form of the circuit, and in practice even an LC circuit will consume some energy because of the non-zero resistance of the components and connecting wires. So consider a simple RL circuit in which resistor and inductor L are connected in series with a voltage supply of V, which is unit is volts. Let us think the current flowing in the circuit is I, which is in ampere, and current through resistor and inductor is IR and IL respectively. Since both resistance and inductor are connected in series, so the current in the both elements and the circuit remains the same. So IR equals to IL equals to I. Let VR and V1 be the voltage drop across the resistor and inductor. Now applying voltage law, Kirchhoff voltage law, sum of voltage drop must be equal to apply voltage to the circuit, and we get V equals to VR plus VO. So let us talk about the phasor diagram for RL circuit. So before drawing the phasor diagram of a series RL circuit, one should know the relationship between voltage and current in case of resistor and inductor. So in case of resistor, the voltage and the current are in same phase, or we can say that phase angle difference between voltage and current is zero. Okay. And in case of inductor, the voltage and the current are not in phase. The voltage leads the that of the current by 90 degree, or in other words, voltage attains maximum and zero value 90 degree before the current attains it. So if we talk about the whole RL circuit, so for whole drawing the phasor diagram for series RL circuit, following four step should be followed. So one by one I will describe all the step. So step one, in case of series RL circuit, resistor and inductor are connected in series, so current flowing in both the elements are same. So IR equals to IL equals to I. which I have already discussed. So take current phasor as reference and draw it on horizontal axis as shown in this diagram. And step 2, in case of resistor, both voltage and current are in same phase. So draw the voltage phasor VR along same axis or direction as that of current phase. So VR is in phase with R. Now step 3, we know that in inductor voltage leads current by 90 degrees, so draw VL. This is VL actually, okay, wait, this is VL. So voltage drop across inductor which is perpendicular to the phasor. Look here, VL is perpendicular to the phasor. And step 4, now we have two voltage VR and VL. So draw the resultant vector VG of these two voltage such as V square R plus V square L equals to V square G. And from the right angle triangle we get phase angle theta equals to tan inverse VL square and VR square. Okay, so this is the phasor diagram and this is the RL series circuit. So if we comes to the conclusion, in case of pure resistive circuit, the phase angle between the voltage and current is zero, and in case of pure inductive circuit, the phase angle is 90 degree, which I have discussed in this slide, before slide. So when we combine both resistance and inductor, the phase angle of a series RL circuit is between 0 degree to 90 degree. So let us talk about the impedance of series RL circuit. The impedance of series RL circuit opposes the flow of alternating current. Impedance of series RL circuit is nothing but the combined effect of resistance R and inductive reactance XL. Look here, of the circuit as a whole, the impedance Z in ohm is given by Z equals to R square plus XL square to the power 0.5. And from right angle triangle, phase angle theta equals to tan inverse XL by R. Look here, we can get the tan theta from here. Okay, so if we talk about the analysis of series RL circuit, in series RL circuit the values of frequency F, voltage V, resistance R and inductance L are known, and there is no instrument for directly measuring the value of inductive reactance and impedance. So for complete analysis of series RL circuit, follow some simple step. So step 1, since the value of frequency and inductor are known, so firstly calculate the value of inductive reactance XL, and value of XL is 2 pi FL in ohm. And step 2, from the value of XL and R, calculate the total impedance of the circuit, which is given by Z equals to root over R square plus XL square. And step 3, calculate the total phase angle for the circuit, which is theta equals to tan inverse XL by R. Step 4, use Ohm's law and find the value of the total current, which is I equals to V by Z ampere. And step 5, calculate the voltage across resistor R and inductor L by using Ohm's law. Since the resistor and the inductor are connected in series, so current in them remains same. Now VR equals to RI, which is in volt, and VL equals to XLI, which is also in volt. So what is power and power triangle in an RL circuit? So in series RL circuit, some energy is dissipated by the resistor and some energy is alternately stored and returned by the inductor. So the instantaneous power delivered by voltage source V is P, and P equals to VI, watts and power distributed by the resistor in form of heat, then P equals to I square R, which is also in watts, and the rate of which energy is stored in inductor, which is equals to P, and P equals to VL into I, and this is equals to Li di by dt. This is also in watts. So the total power in series RL circuit is given by adding the power dissipated by the resistor and the power absorbed by the inductor. So P equals to I square R plus Li di by dt. So this is the power triangle for series RL circuit. Look here. This is true power denoted by P, measured in watt. This is reactive power denoted by Q, measured in VAR. And this is apparent power denoted by S, measured in VA. So this is the whole power triangle. And the electrical power factor cos theta is defined as the ratio of the true power to apparent power. Okay. So this angle is theta, and cos theta power factor equals to true power by apparent power. Now I will talk about the variation of impedance and phase angle with frequency. So the diagram shows the impedance triangle here. The base of this impedance triangle represents resistance. The resistance is independent of frequency. So if frequency increase or decrease, resistance remain constant. The formula for inductive reactance is XL equals to 2 pi FL, which we all know that. So if frequency increase, inductive reactance XL also increase. And if inductive reactance increase, total impedance of circuit also increase. And this leads to variation in phase angle theta, which with frequency. So in series RL circuit, if frequency increase, then inductive reactance also increase, at it is directly proportional to the frequency, and total impedance Z is increase, and phase angle theta also increase. Look at this picture, and finally the resistance remain constant. Okay. So at last of this lecture, I will talk about the expression for current flowing in series RL circuit. So consider a circuit in which resistance is connected in series with inductor and voltage source of V, which unit is volt, is applied across it. Initially the switch is open. Let us say at time t we close the switch and the current I start flowing in the circuit, but it does not attain its maximum value rapidly due to the presence of inductor in the circuit. As we know, inductor has a property to oppose the charge in the current flowing through it. Now apply Kirchhoff voltage law in the circuit, series RL circuit, we get V minus IR minus L di by dt equals to 0. Now rearranging the above equation, we get V minus IR equals to L di by dt, and we can also write dt by L equals to di by V minus IR. Now integrating both sides, we get integration 0 to t dt by L equals to integration 0 to y di by V minus IR, or we can write t by L equals to integration 0 to y di by V minus IR. Now integrate right hand side by using substituting method. We get let z equals to V IR, V minus IR, or dz by di equals to minus R. So substituting the value, we get T by L equals to minus 1 by R dz by z. We know that integration of 1 by z equals to ln z. So we get minus RT by L equals to ln V minus IR 0 to Y. By applying limits, we get minus RT by L equals to ln V minus IR minus ln V. Now simplify again, minus RT by L n VI, V minus IR by V, minus RT by L equals to LN V minus IR by V, taking anti-log on both sides, we get e to the power minus rt by l equals to e to the power ln v minus ir by v. And we know that e to the power ln x equals to x, so we get e to the power minus rt by l equals to v minus ir by v. And from moving the term containing I on one side, we get I equals to V into 1 minus t to the power minus RT by R. The term L by R in the equation is called the time constant tau of the RL series circuit, and it is defined as time taken by the current to reach its maximum steady state value, and the term V by R represent the final steady state value of current in the circuit. About the RC series circuit. So a circuit that contains pure resistance R ohms connected in series with a pure capacitor of capacitance C farad is known as RC series circuit. A sinusoidal voltage is applied and current I flows through the resistance R and the capacitance C of the circuit. So this figure here shown RC series circuit, where VR is the voltage across the resistance, VC is the voltage across the capacitor, V is the total voltage across the RC series circuit. So V equals to Vm sin omega t. So let us discuss about the phasor diagram of RC series circuit. So this picture shown here is the phasor diagram of RC series circuit. So there are some steps to draw the phasor diagram. So first step is take the current I in RMS as a reference vector, okay, and voltage drop in resistance VR equals to IR is taken in phase with the current vector, okay. Next, voltage drop in capacitive reactance VC, which is also equals to IXC, is drawn 90 degree behind the current vector, okay. As current leads voltage by 90 degree in pure capacitive circuit, and the vector sum of the two voltage drop is equals to the applied voltage V, which is in RMS value. Now VR equals to IR, VC equals to IXC, where XC equals to 1 by 2 pi FC. In this triangle OAB, V equals to root over V square plus VC square equals to root over IR square plus IXC whole square, which is equals to V equals to I root over R square plus XC square, or I equals to V by root over R square plus XC square, and which is equals to V by Z, where Z equals to root over R square plus XC square. So Z is the total opposition offered to the flow of alternating current by an RC series circuit and is called impedance. So Z is called impedance of the circuit and it is measured in ohm. So from the phasor diagram here, it is clear that the current in the circuit leads the applied voltage by an angle phi, and this angle is called phase angle. And tan theta equals to VC by VR, VC by VR, okay, which is equals to IXC by IR, and which is equals to XC by R, or we can say theta equals to tan inverse XC by R. Now I will discuss about the power in RC series circuit. So if the alternating voltage applied across the circuit is given by the equation V equals to Vm sin omega t, then I equals to Im sin omega t plus phi, because current lead 90 degree, okay. Therefore the instantaneous power is given by P equals to Vi. Now putting the value of B and I from the equation 1 and 2, in P equals to VI, we get P equals to Vm sin omega t into Im sin omega t plus phi. Now we can say P equals to Vm Im by 2 sin omega t plus phi into sin omega t. And P equals to Vm by root 2 Im by root 2 cos phi minus cos 2 omega t plus phi. And also you can say P equals to Vm by root 2 Im by root 2 cos phi minus Vm by root 2 Im by root 2 cos 2 omega t plus phi. So the average power consumed in the circuit over a complete cycle is given by P equals to average of Vm by root 2 Im by root 2 cos phi minus average of Vm by root 2 Im by root 2 cos 2 omega t plus phi, or P equals to Vm by root 2 Im by root 2 cos phi minus 0, or we can say P equals to Vrms Irms cos phi, which is equals to Vi cos theta phi. Where cos phi is called the power factor of the circuit. So cos phi equals to Vr by V, which is equals to Ir by Iz, which is equals to R by Z. So putting the value of V and cos phi from the equation 3, the value of power will be P equals to Iz I R by Z, which is equals to I square R. So from this equation, power equation, it is clear that the power is actually consumed by the resistance only, and the capacitor does not consume any power in the circuit. Okay, now waveform and power curve of RC series circuit. So the waveform and power curve of the RC series circuit shown here. The various point on the power curve are obtained from the product of the instantaneous value of voltage and current. So the power is negative between the angle 180 degree minus theta and 180 degree, and between 360 degree minus phi and 360 degree, and in the rest of the cycle the power is positive. Since the area under the positive loop is greater than that under the negative loops, therefore the net power over a complete cycle is positive. So look here, this is the phasor of voltage and this is the phasor of current. This is the phasor of power curve. This is the voltage curve, this is the current curve, and this is the simple power curve. Very easy. Okay. Now I will discuss about what is series RLC circuit. So a series RLC circuit is one, the resistor, inductor and capacitor connected in series across the voltage supply. The resulting circuit is called series RLC circuit. A circuit and phasor diagram of a series RLC circuit I will discuss in next slide. So phasor diagram of series RLC circuit. So the phasor diagram of a series RLC circuit is drawn by combining the phasor diagram of resistor, inductor and capacitor. Before doing so, one should understand the relationship between voltage and current in case of resistor, capacitor and inductor. So in case of resistor, the voltage and the current are in same phase, or we can say that the phase angle difference between voltage and current is 0. In case of inductor, the voltage and current are not in phase, the voltage leads of current by 90 degree, or in other words, voltage attained its maximum and zero value 90 degree before the current attained it. And for capacitor, in case of capacitor, the current leads the voltage by 90 degree, or in the other words, voltage attained its maximum and zero value with 0 degree after the current attains it. The phasor diagram of the capacitor is exactly opposite to the inductor. So this is a vector diagram of RLC circuit. So let's talk about details of the phasor diagram. Note that for remembering the phase relationship between voltage and current, learn this simple word called CV. CV, capacitor, current, voltage, current, inductor. Okay. capacitor current leads voltage and voltage leads current in inductor. By this simple word you can remember the relation. So for drawing the phasor diagram of series RLC circuit, following five step would be followed. So step one, in case of series RLC circuit, resistor, capacitor and inductor are connected in series, so the current flowing in all the elements are same. That's mean IR equals to IL equals to IC equals to I. So for drawing the phasor diagram, take current phasor as reference and draw it on horizontal axis as shown in this diagram. Step 2, in case of resistor, both voltage and current are in same phase. So draw the phasor VR along some axis or direction as the current phasor VR is in phase with the current I. Step 3, we know that in inductor voltage leads current by 90 degrees, so draw V1 which is voltage drop of inductor, VL which is voltage drop of inductor, okay, perpendicular to the current phasor in the leading direction. Step 4, in case of capacitor, the voltage lags behind the current by 90 degrees, so draw VC, voltage drop across the capacitor perpendicular to the current phasor in downward direction, okay, so VR, VL, VC. Now for drawing the resultant diagram, draw VC in upward, look here, direction. Now draw resultant VS which is vector sum of voltage VR and VL minus VC, okay, this is VS equals to the vector sum of VR and VL minus VC, so where V square S equals to V square R plus VL minus VC whole square if VL greater than VC, and V square S equals to V square R plus VC minus VL whole square if VL less than VC, and VL equals to VC, then VS equals to VR. So let us talk about the impedance of a series RLC circuit. So the impedance Z of a series RLC circuit defined as the opposition to the flow of current due to circuit resistance R, inductive reactance XL and capacitive reactance is greater than the XC. If the inductive reactance is greater than the capacitive reactance, then XL greater than XC, then RLC circuit has lagging phase angle, and if the capacitive reactance greater than the inductive reactance, then XC greater than XL, then in RLC circuit have leading phase angle. Look here, V square S equals to V square R plus VL minus VC whole square, VR equals to IR, VL equals to IXL, VC equals to IXC, so this become this V square S equals to I square R plus IXL minus IXC whole square, and VS equals to I root over R square plus XL minus XC whole square, or impedance Z equals to root over R square plus XL minus XC whole square. So here, look here, if XL greater than XC, then the RLC circuit has a lagging phase angle, and if the capacitive reactance is greater than inductive reactance, then RLC circuit have leading phase angle, and for XL equals to XC, then circuit will behave as purely resistive circuit. Okay, after this I will discuss about the variation in resistance, reactance and impedance with frequency. So in series RLC circuit, three types of impedance are involved. One is electrical resistance. The resistance is independent of frequency, so it remains constant with change in frequency. Number two is inductive reactance or XL. We know that XL equals to 2 pi FL, so inductive reactance varies directly with frequency. So the graph between frequency and inductive reactance is straight line. passing through the center as shown in this curve. Look here. Number three is capacitive reactance, which is Xc. From the formula of capacitive reactance, Xc equals to 1 by 2 pi Fc. So capacitive reactance varies inversely with the frequency. Since the next reactance is XL minus Xc, so for drawing curve of XL minus Xc, firstly draw the graph of minus Xc, which is shown by curve B. Okay. And then draw a curve for net reactance, which is shown in curve C. So number four, the total impedance of circuit is shown by curve D, okay, which is obtained by adding constant resistor value to the net reactance. So let us talk about some reference book of your course and also for this lecture. So Circuit Theory and Network by S.V. Ghosh and A.K. Chakraborty. This book is very good for diploma and B.Tech engineers. Next, Circuit and System by K.M. Soni. This is the best book according to my choice. And Circuit Theory, Analysis and Synthesis by Abhijit Chakraborty. This is also very simple and good. So thank you. Hope you all enjoy my lecture. And if you have any query, please comment in my comment box. I will definitely reply to your comment. And please like, share and subscribe my channel. So stay safe and stay happy.